We are beginning with yet another twist in the ongoing Pebble Beach art heist. Yesterday, Action News broke the story of a new letter that appeared to be sent to the Monterey County District Attorney's Office by Ben Amadio. He is one of two men who claims to have had millions of dollars of artwork stolen from his Pebble Beach home this past fall. Today, the story took another twist that pits attorneys against their own clients and includes a half-hearted apology, sort of, from a woman who's a new player in the whole thing. Get more details and some help in sorting through the confusion tonight from Action News reporter Felix Cortez.
Well, Dan, as a result of that Monday memo, the attorney for the art collectors has dumped them. She tells me she wants absolutely no part of what she describes as a train wreck. Vicky St. John, the attorney for art collectors Ralph Kanaw and Angelo Benjamin Amadio, describes the controversy, the suspicion surrounding the pair and last fall's multi-million dollar art heist as a tangled mess of spaghetti.
Angelo seems to be the center of controversy. He says he'd love it to go away, but it doesn't seem to be going away soon.
The former Pebble Beach resident claimed to be the victims of the second largest art heist in U.S. history. But in this 30-page memo delivered to the district attorney's office and Action News 8, Amadio is asking the DA to investigate the sheriff's office for allegedly dropping the ball on the investigation. The memo was written by Amadio, a law student, who also asked the DA to drop separate and unrelated check fraud charges against an ex-girlfriend.
There's representation in those cases, and that's who we deal with. We do not deal with erstwhile wannabe attorneys or something of this sort who feel that they have a legal right to demand certain things.
While written by Amadio, the memo was actually sent by Amadio's ex-girlfriend, Sage Ratcliffe, who's been charged with the check fraud. In an email to me Tuesday morning, she says she had no intention of causing anyone harm by sending out the memo. But the damage is done. Ratcliffe's attorney has dropped her, and so has the attorney for Benjamin Amadio and his business partner, Ralph Kanaw. Both lawyers claim they're listed as witnesses in the memo, and that poses a conflict of interest. Amadio's attorney said the art collector made a huge mistake.
I think it's the worst thing he could have done for himself. I think he really muddied the waters for himself and for Ralph and for any other person involved. I just want it known that I absolutely had no part in this train wreck.
What's the best thing Benjamin could do right now?
Be quiet. Absolute best thing he could do is just be quiet, let the dust settle. I don't think he'll do it. I wish him luck, but the more he talks, the deeper he gets into it.
Well, Benjamin Amadio was quiet today and yesterday, but as we see, his actions continue to stir the controversy with his latest stint. His attorney, or his former attorney and law student supervisor, Vicky St. John, has reported him to the State Bar Association for, as she sees it, violating the rules regarding law students. Dan.
All right. Thank you, Felix. And the controversy isn't over for the two art collectors. The sheriff's office continues their investigation for possible fraud.